Good morning, students. I am Sajana and I am going to teach you today class 9 mathematics, irrational numbers. Now, last class we have discussed rational numbers. So, rational numbers you know now are those numbers that can be expressed in the form p by q, where p, q are both integers and q is not equal to 0. At the same time, p, q should not have any common factor other than 1. Now, this class, I'll teach you irrational numbers. So, see, irrational numbers, now again you can define as a number that cannot be expressed in the form p by q, where p, q are both integers and q is not equal to 0. Now, under irrational numbers, you have example root 2, root 3, root 7, root 4, you cannot take as an irrational number because this is root 4 is equal to 2, so a rational number. So, root 4 is not an irrational number. 1 by root 5 you can take as irrational number. Then 2 plus root 3 you can take as irrational number. Like this. Then if we take decimal numbers, like first one, 22.756. So, here, this is a terminating decimal. Hence, this is ending 7 after 756 whole number. So this is called terminating decimal. But the second number 22.25676, it is continuing. So this is called a non-terminating decimal, non-ending. This way, non-terminating decimals, again you can two types you can define, like first one recurring, like the which is repeating, like 2.3333. So then 75.16116, 3.75755, so it's repeating, known as recurring decimal. And the other one called non-recurring, like 2.345123. Not repeating, 16.252627, 10.223344, not repeating these numbers. So here, therefore, this non-terminating recurring decimals you can take as rational numbers, but non-recurring decimals are irrational numbers. So you can write, therefore, these two points are decimal number which is non-terminating and non-recurring is also called irrational number. And then again you have seen the root of numbers which is not a perfect square is also an irrational number. Now let us discuss some sums here from exercise 1.2 based on irrational numbers. So first question, prove that root 5 is an irrational number. Come to solution. Let us prove this by contradiction method. So here, let root 5 be a rational number, then root 5 we can write is equal to p by q, where p and q belongs to integers, q is not equal to 0. And p and q have no common factor except 1. So, squaring both sides, root 5 square is equal to p by p square by q square. So, you get 5 is equal to p square by q square. Then cross multiplying, 5q square is equal to p square, that is p square is equal to 5q square we get. So this is first equation. So you get therefore 5 is a factor of p square, and therefore you can write 5 is also a factor of p. So suppose this is equation 2. Now let us take p is equal to 5m, where m is an integer. Now since p square is equal to 5 square, that is you got in equation 1, and now substituting the value of p here, so you write 5m whole square is equal to 5q square, that comes 25m square is equal to 5q square. So ultimately you get cancelling, you get 5m square is equal to q square. Therefore you can write again q square is equal to 5m square. So here again you find 5 is the factor of q square. Therefore you can write 5 is also a factor of q. So let us this be equation 3. Now from equation 2 and 3, we can say therefore both p and q have a common factor, that is 5. This contradicts that p and q have no common factor except 1, isn't so? Therefore, hence you can write root 5 is not a rational number, so root 5 is an irrational number. Alright. Sum number 2 now. So, prove that root 7 is an irrational number. Now, see the sum, how to solve. Here, suppose root 7 be a rational number. So we can write in the form p by q, and where p and q are integers and they do not have any common factor except 1. So you can write therefore root 7 is equal to p by q. Now squaring both sides, root 7 square is equal to p square by q square. So ultimately you get 7 is equal to p square by q square, cross multiply now. So you get therefore p square is equal to 7q square. This, suppose this is first equation. So you can write therefore 7 is a factor of p square. Therefore you can write 7 is also a factor of p. So let this be the second equation. So first you prove therefore here 7 is a factor of p. Now again second step, let p is equal to 7m, where again m is an integer. Therefore you can write 7m square is equal to 7q square, because you have to substitute the value of p in the first equation. So you get then 49m square is equal to 7q square. Therefore you get 7 cancelling both sides by 7, you get 7m square is equal to q square. So ultimately therefore you can write q square is equal to 7m square. So again you can say 7 is a factor of q square, so 7 is also a factor of q. So from these two both the equations you get then 7 is a factor of p as well as 7 is a factor of q. So this, let this be the third equation. So now from the second and third equation you can say that both p and q have common factor 7. Thus it contradicts our supposition, and there hence you can tell that root 7 is an irrational number. Let us take sum number 4 now. You have to prove here 1 by root over 11 is an irrational number. So again, same way, let us take 1 by root over 11 is equal to p by q, because if you take, suppose this is a rational number, so 1 by 11 is equal to p by q, therefore 1 by 11 is equal to p square by q squares by squaring both the sides. So ultimately you get therefore q square is equal to 11 p square. Suppose this is first equation. Now you can say therefore 11 is a factor of q square, therefore 11 is also a factor of q. Let this be the second equation. Now again, second part, let q is equal to 11m. So you can say therefore 11m square is equal to 11p square, because when you put the value of q 11m in the place of first equation, so you get 11m square is equal to 11p square. So ultimately you get here 11 here 121 m square is equal to 11p square. Then follow again from here, that is 11 m square is equal to p square. So you can say therefore 11 is a factor of p square, same way. So you can say 11 is also a factor of p. Now therefore p and q have a common factor 11. Again, so same process, you can write, it contradicts that p q have no common factor except one. Hence you can tell 1 by root 11 is an irrational number. Now one more question you take from here. Some number 8, third one you take. You have to prove here that the following numbers are irrational. Let us take the third sum, that 2 root 3 minus 7 is an irrational number. You have to prove here. Same way, take first, let 2 root 3 minus 7 is equal to a rational number. So you can write therefore 2 root 3 is equal to a plus 7. Shift 7, right side. So you can therefore you write root 3 is equal to a plus 7 by 2. So complete the equation, ultimately you get cross multiply, you get 2 root 3 is equal to a plus 7. Therefore root 3 is equal to a plus 7 by 2. Now see both sides. Now in right hand side you can write therefore a is a rational number, you can you have assumed, and 7 is also a rational number, therefore a plus 7 is also a rational number, then 2 is a rational number. So ultimately a plus 7 by 2 is also a rational number. And in right hand side you can write, you can take 3 is not a perfect square, therefore root 3 is an irrational number. Therefore left hand side is not equal to right hand side, so you can say 2 root 3 minus 7 is an irrational number. Alright, now practice more sums from this exercise, and next class again we are going to discuss real numbers. Alright.